ओके, स्क्रीन इज विजिबल टू एवरीवन?
यस
यस
मैम,
यस मैम,
यस मैम,
ओके. आशा, प्लीज स्टार्ट विथ योर सेमिनार. ऑल द बेस्ट.
थैंक यू मैम. आई वाज गुड मॉर्निंग मैम एंड गुड मॉर्निंग डियर फ्रेंड्स. माय नेम इज आशा विटेकर. टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू स्टार्ट माय सेमिनार. माय टॉपिक इज रोल ऑफ एजुकेशनल सुपरवाइजर एंड हेडमास्टर. Our subject code is 201. The name of subject is quality and management of school. And the subtopic is role and qualities of human resources. From that, I'm going to introduce educational supervisor and headmaster's role and responsibilities. Introduction about human resource management. Dear friends, you know, human resource management is a critical element to starting and operating a successful school. School needs a strong director. It also needs talented and dedicated teachers and a competent business staff. Because if we want to run or a direct a school, then we have to have operating a successful school management. Supervisor and headmaster and human resources, including principal and teachers and parents, commonly presumed to play a key role in turnaround. Dear friends, we know about human resource management. We are going to talk about educational supervisor. If we individually called a responsible of supporting. Let's see what is an educational supervisor. Next slide, please, ma'am. An educational supervisor. Some definitions are given below. Supervision is the creative and dynamic process giving friendly guidance and direction to teachers and pupils for improving themselves and the teaching learning situation for the accomplishment of the desired goals of education. This definition is written by R.P. Bhatnagar and I.B. Verma. What he has said in this, supervision is a creative and dynamic process. Isn't it? Supervision is a creative and dynamic process, because if you want to supervise something, we need a dynamic process and guidance to direct teachers and all the children from the school to improve themselves from learning and teaching situation. Dear friends, can somebody tell me what is supervision? Okay, let's see the next. Supervision is an expert technical service primarily concerned with the studying and improving the condition that surround learning and the pupil growth, is written by A.S. Barr. Dear friends, supervision means an all-out efforts of the school officials directed towards providing leadership to teachers. Do we get that? Supervision means all-out efforts of the school official directed towards providing leadership teachers and educational workers for the improvement of institution or a school. And it involves both human and material elements. The human elements are pupils, parents, and teachers, and the employees. The educational supervision, do you understand, dear friends, what is educational supervision? Okay, let's see the next slide. Ma'am, next slide, please. Role and responsibilities of supervision. Role and responsibilities of supervision means what the role plays a supervisor, or what responsibilities he has That's why let's see the roles and responsibilities of supervisor meeting to trainees. The educator meeting to trainees and the educators. The educational supervisor should meet regularly with the trainees to review educational progress and to encourage reflection and the collection of appropriate supporting information on all aspects of good medical practice for revalidation. Dear friends, meeting to trainees means when a supervisor, educational supervisor, is going to take meeting to meet someone on a basis, a regular basis, then he should review the progress of a school and to encourage the reflection and the collection of appropriate support in supporting information. Means in school there are so many things we conduct or we direct. We have to assist the teachers and we have to support them and we have to take some commitments from them to improve this. Let's see the next. Direct assistance. Direct assistance to teachers is one of the crucial elements of a successful school. I mean, if you want to direct teachers, it's element is very crucial. It's very hard. For a successful school, supervision provides direct assistance to the teachers as it a continuous focuses on improvement of the classroom instruction. If the supervisor is directing the assistance, it's a very crucial duty because it's a very hard work to do it. Because if they want to do improvement in their school or classroom instruction, the supervisor provides them. They assist them. Ma'am, next slide, please. Curriculum development. Curriculum development is the core element of school. The curriculum development is the core of a school existence. What is to be taught to our students is matter that but by definition exists outside the province of an individual teachers for individual classroom. Dear friends, curriculum, why we need curriculum? Because curriculum development is for the improvement of instruction. Why we need curriculum? Because we need to do improvement of instruction. Curriculum develops so many things because it is necessary to do improvement due to need of enhancing collective thinking about instruction or become the major function of instruction supervision or designing or redesigning that which is to be taught. Let's see the next. Group development. Group development provides meeting where groups of teachers can work together to solve the problems. Group development, as it is necessary for instructional improvement due to the ability of the group to come together and discuss what is working and what needs improvement. Group development, dear friends, what is the meaning of group development? Can somebody tell me? Okay, let's see. The group development, what is group development? The group development that we form teachers together to solve the problems. Because by working together instructions will be improved, the students' learning will be enhanced, group work enhanced, the knowledge of teachers at a different development levels it will improve. Because of that, group development is very necessary. Professional development. Professional development is a part of enhancing the instruction of teachers, any experience that enlarge teachers' knowledge, appreciations, and skills and understanding of a work falls under the domain of professional development. Now see, professional development means what? Enhancing the instruction of teachers. Enhancing means, because we can take an example. If in a school, the teacher has a good knowledge, good skills, we have to appreciate them. We have to appreciate them. Work falls under the domain professionals, or skillful teachers and competent teachers are very crucial for successful schools. Professional development is a major function of the school supervision. Next slide, please, ma'am. Headmaster and principal. Dear friends, headmaster and principal is the headmaster and the principal is the same word. We can call headmaster or principal. Headmaster is a position often remain known as a senior teacher of the school, means head of the school. We can call head teacher or a headmistress, means whenever female or male, we can call headmaster, headmistress, like that. Or a leader to manage of all school work. A school tends to rise, fall on the personality, competence of the headmaster. That's why we need a school principal. School principal are the words of learning and managing supervisors of the school. They provide visions and leadership to all stakeholders in the school and create a safe and peaceful environment to the school. Dear friends, headmaster, it plays an important role in the school, playing organization and supervision, as well as teaching and guiding and counseling and maintaining relations with the teachers. And missions of learning and educating at the highest level of guidance, the day-to-day school business, and oversee all activities conducted by the school. Whatever activities are going to conduct by school, everything has to be managed by headmaster or a principal. She has to oversee all activities. The responsibilities of all this decision making and are accountable for their efforts to evaluate the school. They need to do very hard efforts to evaluate the school to take the best level in learning and achievements for the students, best teaching skills for the teachers, and best work environment for support staff. If the headmaster is going to play a big role in the school, she has to do a best work to support the staff. Ma'am, next slide. Role and responsibilities of headmaster. Dear friends, when a headmaster is going to play a important role in school and playing in organization or supervision, they plan according to that. Role in planning. Planning is the first and foremost duty of the head of school. They has to have planned number of things in the school with the cooperation of the teachers and the pupils and the parents and general public. Planning goes on throughout the year. Now, role in planning means if the headmaster is going to plan a role according to the cooperation of teachers, means when she's going to plan this, she has to take a cooperation of teachers, students and parents, and in general public. This planning goes throughout the years because it doesn't stay in a 1 year. It just continues the years. Second is role in school organization. Subtopic of role in school organization, how she manage the work. Organizing instructional work. The head of the school must organize the instruction work. They will ask the teachers to divide the year's work into smaller units. If they are going to organize the instructional work, they must organize in the units. Because in a year, how much we should divide the work? They take the timetable. They create a timetable and they classify pupils' timetable with that role of organization. Organizing co-curricular activities. The headmaster must organize activities of the school with the cooperation to staff and students. When they want to organize co-curricular activities, they should take a cooperation of staff and students. There are so many school activities like sports, scouting, girl guiding, Red Cross, parents, teachers, association, celebration of religious and social functions on and festivals, etc. I mean, if they want to organize the whole year activities, how they are going to function it that? Because if they organize properly, they put a timetable according to that, then they can do these activities according to the timetable or according to the organization. Third is teacher's role. The headmaster must share instructional work with the teachers and should consider themselves as first and last, because headmaster is sharing the instructional work with the teachers. Then they should consider themselves as a first teacher and the last teacher, because nobody is going to conduct their role, because they want to do their own work, because the teacher's position they can't give anyone. And the teaching should, wherever they are going to work, the teacher's achievement of the students. The headmaster understand the problems of teachers and pupils to make better he or himself as a their teachers. Ma'am, next slide please. Role in supervision. The headmaster of the school should not simply sit in office. They should supervise the work of the school here and there and everywhere. Dear friends, when the headmaster is doing a supervision role, she can't sit in one place. She has to go here and there. She has to check everything. Everything is going properly and how she has instructed to everyone. And she has to supervise the instructional work. And she has to go around of the classroom, wherever, however, it is not to be fault-finding business, but the headmaster should supervise the activities going on the playground, hall, art room, library, or workshop. They should supervise the proper use of keep up of school materials. In general, we can say supervise the behavior of students, provide facilities to maintain the cleanness of the campus. The role of supervision. Thank you, everyone.
Okay, students, if you have any query, please ask to Asha. Yes, no queries. You understood the entire topic? Yes or no? You don't have any question? Yes, I want responses from your side. If you don't have any question, then please say we don't have.
Yes, ma'am.
You understood the entire topic, role and qualities of human resources, that is supervisor and headmaster, we can say principal. Yes?
More example I want in supervisor.
Okay. Yes, yes, Asha, can you give more examples regarding supervisor's duties, we can say, role and qualities or responsibilities, we can say. Yes, okay. Asha?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. I'll give.
Okay, should I move to this on slide? Yes.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, please.
Which slide you want? The introductory slide you want or the next slide you want? Yes.
The role and responsibility. No, the first the
definition slide. Okay, okay, okay. Yes.
Wait, ma'am, the internet connection is low. Wait, wait, give me 1 minute.
But your voice is clearly audible, Asha.
No, ma'am, it's just blinking it.
That's okay, right. Okay, okay, okay.
I'm plugging to a charger.
Okay, no problem.
Yes, ma'am. Now I'm audible, ma'am?
Yes, yes, you're audible.
Now, see, the definition has been given on the slide. What is an educational supervisor? Supervision is the creative and dynamic process. Means if we want to supervise, we have to go with a friendly nature and the whatever directions and whatever the guidance we have to give to the teachers or pupils, we have to give them by friendly nature or by teaching and learning process. Now the example of educational supervisor is that if we want if the teachers are appointed in the schools and we want to just because some teachers are having some problems in schools, okay, and the supervisor went, and because without without doing
yes, Asha,
yes, ma'am, yes, ma'am, without supervising the entire topic, a teacher comes and asks the supervisor the problems what she's facing just now, right now. Then the educational supervisor go through that and he gives the advice for the teachers how to solve the problem. Means he just don't say that I'm not able to solve the problem. Whatever it is, how his ideas created to solve the problems, he just creates the teachers. Sometimes teachers are having some problem while teaching and they don't have a teaching aid. Because sometimes how the school background is there, the school does cannot provide the teaching aids for teachers. Then they can go and tell the supervisor that I am facing the problem of this kind of problem, please can you solve this problem? Then supervisors go through this and he solves the problem on in his way to get a good teaching to pupils or a good guidance for teacher how to manage the class or how to manage a teaching aids from the school.
Okay, Asha. See, students, in short, we can say this supervisor, we can say he is a mediator between. See, there are three levels. So we can say if we see the hierarchy, there are three levels of managers, the higher level, middle level, and lower level. Mm-hmm. So here, supervisor, he came under the middle level manager, and we can say He is a supervisor. He is a mediator between the higher level managers and the lower level managers. So who came under the higher level managers? The principal and the trustee members, they come under the higher level managers, and teachers, they come under the lower level managers. So here, what supervisor is doing? He is making friendly relationship between the higher level managers and the lower level managers. So whatever problems or whatever needs the staff, or we can say the teaching staff, or we can say the entire staff, they are having. So the needs, what is the duty of the supervisor to So whatever problems they are facing, the supervisor put all the problems in front of the higher administrator, we can say. Okay, so he work as a mediator between the principals and the teaching staff, we can say. And if we see the duties of supervisor, we can divide the duties of supervisor in two parts, like academic duties are different and administrative duties are different. Okay, so can you give me one example of academic duty? Yes.
Academic duty.
See, just now you told the guiding to the teachers. Or see, for proper work, there should be work culture. So
coordinate.
Yes, improvement in the working environment. Okay, then even the coordination between the different educational activities. So these are the examples of the what you can say examples of the academic duties which supervisor supposed to
do.
Yeah. Do okay, and the what comes under the administrative duties?
Administrative duties. How the curriculum is going on.
See, for example, as a supervisor, he's supposed to maintain different types of records. Okay. Even if we see the hierarchy, he comes under the below the principal. So almost whatever work principal is doing, almost I think 70 to 80% the same work doing by the supervisor you do. Okay. Anything else, students? You want to ask some more questions to Asha? Yes. Yes, students.
No, ma'am.
No questions.
The material is sufficient for us.
Okay. See, Asha,
yes,
I'm going to ask you questions. Be ready for that. Okay. You have conducted your seminar very nicely. You explained the entire topic very nicely.
Mm-hmm.
And what I like, the first slide was the definition of the supervisor. And actually, you started your seminar with the introduction of with the definition of the supervisor. Okay. And the next was the role and responsibilities of the principal, or you can say the headmaster. Okay. Suppose if I want to categorize the responsibilities of a principal in three parts, like the responsibilities of a principal before the commencement of the academic year, during the academic year, and during the end of the academic year. Okay. So as a principal, what responsibilities he's supposed to do? Give me one example of each. We'll start with the first part, that is responsibility of a principal before the commencement of the academic year. Just give me examples.
Role in planning before the academic year. The headmaster should plan the entire year.
Okay. So what there is a specific word for that. So what is that? That is nothing but the principal is planning for the particular academic year. So there is a specific word for that. That is nothing but
co-curricular activities.
No, the co-curricular activity is the one part. But before that, he have to take care of all the activities, curricular as well as co-curricular activities. Okay. So that is nothing but we can say the academic planning, or you can say the annual planning. Okay. So that is nothing but the annual timetable. It can be a consolidated timetable, it can be class-wise timetable, it can be teacher-wise timetable. Okay. Do you remember some other examples?
Ma'am, planning of syllabus as per the working days.
See, That is nothing but the, see, that comes under the entire planning, that is timetable. Okay.
Timetable, yes.
When teacher is supposed to finish the particular syllabus, when they should take the first unit test, when there is a term examination. Okay. So entire, it is reflect, entire things reflected, you can say the curricular as well as co-curricular things reflected in the annual timetable. So they also prepare the class-wise timetable and the teacher-wise timetable. Even before the commencement of the academic year, they should take care of the stationaries. If there is a need of a stationery, they supposed to purchase all necessary stationery, even the furnitures also. Then if we see, there is a distribution of the work among the teaching as well as non-teaching staff. It is there. Then they supposed to do the process of admission. Always it is done before the commencement of the academic year. Okay, so these are the principles. Okay, now I want the next example. What are the responsibilities of a principal during the academic year?
Allotment of the subjects to the teachers according to their educational qualifications. Then planning of everything.
Yeah, of course, see, it's a basic plan, is it is done in previously, but again there may be flexibility, and again the, as a principal she's supposed to work on the same again and again. So here he should organize the various curricular and co-curricular activities, okay, for the particular academic year. Even she should take care of the implementation of the different tutorial exam, unit test, even the term exam, we can say a final exam. Okay, even we can say that PTA meetings also. Okay,
yeah,
so all these are the duties principal supposed to do in the during the academic year. And at the end of the academic year, what are the responsibilities of the principal at the end of the academic year? Yes. No. See, just consider academic year. Suppose like any academic year, it starts in the month of June. Okay, here I'm considering the state board, SSC and HSC board of Maharashtra. So usually it starts in the month of June. Okay, and it's end in the month of March, April.
March,
okay, April. So just consider academic. Yes. So what are the responsibilities of a principal at the end of the academic year?
Because she has to make a the reports of report cards of the school, entire school children.
Yes,
means the nice. Teachers are making the report cards, but she has to check that things, it is going in a proper way or not. And now the fees, the fee structure, who has paid the fees, means in the end of the year, yes, she has to manage that also.
Okay.
In the whole year, a yes, whole year, how much she has means what are the active means what are the changes she want to have in the next year, she's going to manage with means she will discuss that with the teachers, she will arrange a meeting and she will discuss with the teachers.
So simply we can say the declaration of the result, even the issuing the leaving certificates. Okay, suppose the school, it is till 10th. Okay, so after completion of the 10th standard, they have to also think about the issuing the leaving certificates. And even as Asha just now, she said about the students' fees. Okay, suppose they are not filled their fees yet, then they can think about the dues. Even you also giving dues for the, if you are not if you are not retaining your books in the library in time, for that purpose again you have to pay the dues. Okay,
and she has to maintain she has to
yes, Rupi.
I want to add one more point.
Yes,
for Rupi. The next academic session, mm-hmm, whether the book should she should continue it to the next year, or change of books also she
yes
need to consider.
Yes,
that our is principal needs to consider.
Yes, that
choice
is
of the
yes, which books they are going to what we can say. See, basically what happened, if the school, it comes under the particular state or particular state board, then there is a fixed criteria. They're supposed to consider the syllabus, or what you can say, the curriculum laid by the government of particular government of particular state. Okay, that is the thing. But some schools, they are IB schools, even they are the in the national schools are there, international schools are there, they are following some different syllabus. So they can think about the which publications they should take in the particular, for the particular academic year, for the particular standard. That is the thing. Am I right, Rupti?
Yes, ma'am. That's what I want to tell.
Okay.
And one more thing, ma'am. Whether the students are getting the correct material to read or not.
Yes.
That also she has to think. The principal has to think. And if wants to add some material to that.
Okay.
That part also may be considered.
Yes, very true.
And the repairing things or the things which should be added to the labs and science lab ho ya maths lab ho ya
yes
SST geography ke liye jo mapping wagere lagta hai, so everything.
See, as a principal, is supposed to follow all the functions of management. Okay, so if you are thinking about the commencements of the particular academic, starting of the particular academic year, so he should plan something. And if we see that the end of the academic year, he should evaluate the things. Okay, so whatever activities he plan, whatever activities he implement, so whether is there any need of the changing in the plan. So he have to take care of anything, okay, everything. Okay. Yes, Meenal, you want to add something?
Ma'am, principal ko academic ki last mein ek important work ye bhi rehta hai, according to result wo teachers ko reshuffle karna. Is it that like ki wo ye subject zyada acche se padha rahe hain ya changes of
teachers? Yes.
Yes, what we exactly want to say? Yes, Meenal.
I want to say that, ma'am, this result declare hua at the end of the year.
Mm-hmm.
So principal according to result bhi teachers ko reshuffle karte hain, like that aap ye subject acha aapka result aaya hai to next class mein promote bhi karna unko, like.
Yes. See, it is depend on the higher level managers. Okay. For example, kya hote? Same students they carry forward hote in the next class. Okay. So if the teacher is comfortable with the particular group of students, and even the same thing regarding the students, or students are also comfortable with the teacher. So if there is good bonding and there is a good process of teaching learning, then there is a what happen? Suppose the particular teacher is teaching on the fifth grade. Okay. On the A division. So automatically the students in the next academic year, they will go in the, they will promoted in the sixth grade. So automatically the teacher, he will teach the same subject in the next grade. Okay, that happens, right? Okay, anything else you want to share, anything? Yes, anyone want to add anything, please?
Ma'am, I want to say one thing, that I have given that example, that educational supervisor, that he is the middle process, means he is in the middle of process. Okay.
Yes.
Now
yes.
I gave the example of a supervisor. Then when the problems are very little, then he can manage his own.
As we know, all these are the leaders. Even the teachers are also leaders. So as per the need, they can implement any style of leadership. For example, even the supervisor is very capable, he is very experienced. Okay, so at that time, what principal will do, he will see, now you are capable enough, now you can take care of all these things. So here the supervisor, so in absence of principal also, the supervisor can take decisions. Okay
ma'am.
Okay, understood the entire topic. Some more points are there. I will share the notes later. Okay. Okay, Asha.
Yes, ma'am.
Thank you so much for conducting your presentation very nicely. Though there was very serious condition at your home, I really appreciate your work. Okay.
Yes, ma'am. See, thank you so much for supporting me.
You're always welcome. See, what happened? If you're having any problem at your home, please share with your teachers.
Yes, ma'am.
आप अगर बोलोगे नहीं हमें कैसे पता चलेगा आपका क्या प्रॉब्लम्स है. ठीक है, ओके, थैंक यू सो मच. ओके, आई थिंक दिस इज 1:31, वी शुड एंड अवर लेक्चर अवर सेशन. ओके, थैंक यू सो मच. नाउ आई एम गोइंग टू एंड दिस मीटिंग.
थैंक यू मैम.
थैंक यू.